This short tutorial concerns the economic dispatch of generation units on a time horizon of a few minutes to over 100 minutes. The tutorial is not intended to cover settlements which involves payment to generators by load. It also does not cover the multi-state energy imbalance market or EIM. Here we are concerned with 15 minutes processes within the California Independent System Operator Balancing Authority inside the state of California. Section 34 of the CAISO Tariff and Section 7 of the CAISO Business Practice Manual for Market Operations detail the processes of the CAISO real-time market. The real-time market opens to bids of supply and forecasts of demand at 1300 or 1 p.m. the day prior to the trading day, or when the day-ahead market results are published. The real-time market closes 75 minutes before the trade hour. Energy and ancillary services required to serve load and balance the grid are produced by generation units. In the event of a grid disturbance or a scarcity of imbalance energy supply on the grid, the ISO manages the stability of the grid by converting ancillary services capacity into energy in real time. The CAISO real-time market consists of multiple processes, or applications, which in the words of the BPM are multi-interval optimization functions minimizing the cost of dispatching imbalance energy, and procuring additional ancillary services, when applicable, subject to resource and network constraints. Think of imbalance energy as the difference between schedule energy flows, day-ahead market schedule for instance, and the actual meter readings. The real-time applications use sub-hourly time intervals within their time horizon. The applications run at periodic intervals, every 5 or 15 minutes, with a time horizon that ends at or beyond the time horizon of the previous run. In real-time, demand is continuously changing. Without storage and responsive demand, the output of some generators must change to follow constantly changing demand. This practice is known as load following. System operators use economic dispatch to optimize the use of all available generation units and minimize real-time costs. In centrally coordinated balancing areas like the CAISO, for a given load profile, the ISO's real-time applications determine which units start up, shut down, and transition between generation output levels to meet the load or instantaneous demand at minimum cost. To follow load throughout a 24-hour day, the continuous load profile is decomposed into set periods of time. These are 1-hour periods for the day-ahead market, and 15-minute periods in the real-time market. For each time period, the associated application determines which units should be committed to generate. For the real-time market, this is referred to as real-time unit commitment or RTUC. This presentation covers the 15-minute market and its RTUC application called Real-Time Pre-Dispatch or PD for short. There are also 5-minute processes, but those are topic for another presentation. In the following simplified example of unit commitment, consider this hypothetical one bus system with a single load profile representing all customers a load serving entity must serve. To supply the load, 3 generation units are available. For simplicity, load and generation are all on the single bus. Unit commitment is the process the ISO follows to start up, shut down, and transition the units over time to meet the time variant load. To make commitment decisions, the ISO has knowledge of each unit's physical characteristics, which include capacity in megawatts, start-up time, transition time, shutdown time, maximum ramp rate, and minimum operation level. Continuing with the simple example, the load profile over a period of time divided into 15-minute intervals is the area under the curve. With 3 units available to follow load, the following can be seen. Unit 1 is shown operating at full production for all 15-minute intervals in the example. It is assumed that Unit 1 started in a prior interval before the example because all units have a finite start-up time. To follow the increasing demand of the load profile, Unit 2 is started in the second 15-minute interval. Unit 2 ramps up to reach its capacity by the beginning of the fourth 15-minute interval. Unit 2 remains at full production during the fifth 15-minute interval. During the fourth 15-minute interval, the production of Units 1 and 2 is insufficient to satisfy demand of the load profile curve. Therefore, Unit 3 must produce at a fraction of its capacity during the peak demand. Starting in the fifth 15-minute interval, the demand of the load profile decreases. To avoid surplus supply, Unit 3 is shut down. Unit 2 is ramped down during the sixth 15-minute interval and shut down during the seventh interval. By the eighth interval, only Unit 1 is operating. During the eighth interval, Unit 1 is transitioning to a lower production level as demand continues to decrease. To reiterate, generation units have physical constraints. They take time to start up, shut down, and transition. This implies that the units are receiving coordinated instructions from the ISO prior to each interval. Ultimately, the system operator is more of a coordinator, rather than an entity with exclusive control to manage commitment of units. For a variety of reasons, some listed on this page, the ISO depends on the market participants to follow instructions. Instructions are essentially production schedules for a generation unit, and would involve a start-up, a shutdown, or transition. Binding instructions have financial implications, and binding instructions would therefore involve one or more settlement processes. Note that settlement is not covered in this tutorial. Advisory instructions make a recommendation concerning production schedule but lack any financial implication. The available mix of generation units, as well as the configuration of the electric network, varies over time because of the reasons listed on this slide. Consequently, the inputs to the ISO state estimator vary over time, and the ISO must re-optimize unit commitment for each 15-minute interval. As mentioned on an earlier slide, the processes, or applications, of the real-time market include the hour-ahead scheduling process or Hesp, the real-time unit commitment or RTUC and RTUC's associated 15-minute market, the short-term unit commitment or STUC, the real-time economic dispatch or RTED, the real-time manual dispatch, and the real-time contingency dispatch. This tutorial focuses on Hesp and RTUC. RTUC is also known by the term, real-time pre-dispatch or simply PD. There are four stages of PD, PD7, which is the same as Hesp, and then PD6, PD5, and PD4. Each of these RTUC applications follow the same general outline. The process takes inputs such as the state estimator solution from the energy management system, the prior market results and self-schedules, the CalISO forecast of CalISO demand, and the scheduled exports. The application iteratively evaluates multiple feasible solutions. This is like in the example where units were committed and decommitted to follow demand of the load profile curve. With the pre-dispatch applications, the aforementioned inputs as well as the network model are utilized to identify feasible solutions. Finally, the pre-dispatch application selects the most optimized feasible solution, which contains a table of unit commitments. The table is the basis for unit commitment instructions, one binding and multiple advisory, which are transmitted to the individual generation units via the automated dispatch system, or ADS. Note that since optimization timeline is at most 105 minutes, only certain generation unit types may be committed by PD applications. Now we will look at real-time pre-dispatch 7, which is better known as Hesp. Hesp functionality is embedded in the RTUC application. Hesp or PD7 is the first of four RTUC runs. Here are some quick facts about Hesp. It is an hourly pre-dispatch for hourly block bid system resources, which include interties. All other resources, including both energy and ancillary services, which are internal to the CalISO balancing area, are awarded on an advisory basis in 15-minute intervals. For Hesp, the second 15-minute interval is binding. Hesp also defines binding hourly ancillary services awards for non-dynamic system resources. Hesp or PD7 follows approximately the same timeline each hour for all 24 hours each day, at no later than the 47-minute and 30-seconds mark of each hour. PD7 samples market results including generation awards, self-schedules of supply and demand, state estimator solution, CalISO forecast of CalISO demand, and scheduled exports to adjacent balancing areas. During the following few minutes but no later than the 7-minute and 30-second mark of the next hour, PD7 performs an iterative computation to identify the most optimal feasible unit commitment solution. At no later than the 7-minute and 30-second mark of the next hour, the unit commitment decision, published as 15-minute market results, are made available individually to generation units through ADS, and globally through OASIS. Let's analyze the figures of this slide beginning at the upper left. Figure A. Figure A shows the 47-minute and 30-seconds mark of the hour where Hesp, aka PD7, samples the inputs. The PD7 computation is completed at latest by the 7-minute and 30-second mark of the next hour. PD7 transmits unique instructions for a total of 7 15-minute intervals through ADS to all committed units. That's totals 105 minutes clockwise. The instructions contain start UPS, shutdowns, and transitions between multiple generation levels. Intervals 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 are advisory, while interval 2 is binding. The PD7 instructions commence at the 15-minute mark of the hour. Figure B shows the 15-minute interval spanning the 30-minute to 45-minute marks of the hour, which is binding. There are settlement implications associated with how each committed unit follows or fails to follow its instruction in this interval. Next, figure C shows the advisory 15-minute interval spanning the 45-minute to 60-minute mark. Figures D through G show the remaining advisory 15 intervals for the PD7 application. Figure H is an aggregated representation of figures A through G. Like figure A, in a clockwise fashion, observe the sampling of inputs at mark 47:30, the results at no later the 7:30 mark of the next hour, the start of instructions at the 15-minute mark, the binding second interval instructions between the 30 and 45-minute marks, and the subsequent remaining advisory intervals 3 through 7. Now for the remaining pre-dispatch applications. PD6, PD5, and PD4 functionality are also embedded in the RTUC application. Similar to Hesp, or PD7, the second 15 interval of each of these applications is binding. PD6 is very similar to PD7, except that it doesn't consider hourly block bids and interties. PD6 follows approximately the same timeline each hour for all 24 hours each day. PD6 samples inputs at the 7:30 mark of the hour. During the following few minutes but no later than the 22:30 mark, PD6 performs iterative computation to identify the most optimal feasible unit commitment solution. At no later than the 22:30 mark, PD6's unit commitment decision, published as 6 15-minute market results, is made available in the form of instruction individually to committed generation units through ADS, and globally through OASIS. PD6 produces 6 15-minute intervals for 90 minutes total clockwise instruction. PD6 instructions commence at the 30-minute mark each hour, and only the second 15-minute interval between the 45 and 60-minute marks is binding. Intervals 3 through 6 are advisory. Next, PD5 samples inputs at the 22:30 mark of the hour. During the following few minutes but no later than the 37:30 mark, PD5 performs an iterative computation to identify the most optimal feasible unit commitment solution. At no later than the 37:30 mark, the unit commitment decision, published as 5 15-minute market results, are made available individually to generation units through ADS, and globally through OASIS. PD5 produces 5 15-minute intervals for 75 minutes total clockwise of instructions. PD5 instructions commence at the 45-minute mark, and only the second 15-minute interval between the 0 and 15-minute marks of the next hour is binding. Intervals 3 through 5 are advisory. PD4 samples inputs at the 37:30 mark of the hour. During the following few minutes but no later than the 60-minute mark, note this is less available computation time due to upcoming Hesp hour, PD4 performs an iterative computation to identify the most optimal feasible unit commitment solution. At no later than the 60-minute mark, the unit commitment decision, published as 4 15-minute market results, are made available individually to generation units through ADS, and globally through OASIS. PD4 produces 4 15-minute intervals for 60 minutes total clockwise of instructions. PD4 instructions commence at the 60-minute mark, and only the second 15-minute interval between the 15 and 30-minute marks of the next hour is binding. Intervals 3 and 4 are advisory. Take note that each application produces its own binding second interval, so there are 4 binding 15-minute intervals in every hour. Fresh pre-dispatch applications, PD7, PD6, PD5, and PD4, occur for the following hour and for hours beyond. That is the RTUC or real-time pre-dispatch process.